4 years ago, somebody told me I would be standing on a stage and I would have a room full of adults listening to me. I would not have believed them. But yet here I am. So how did I get here? And why should you listen to me? My name is Ritik Mehta. I'm 14 years old. I'm a digital native of the purest kind. I've never used tapes or vinyl or non-digital cameras. I attended TEDxKids in Brussels 4 years ago, and now I organize TEDxYouth at Flanders since 3 years. And I do that with my father and my sister. I'm here to tell you what happened to my life after TEDxKids in Brussels, what I learned from those experiences, and how I see the future of society and education. All of this started by being at the right place at the right time. The place was Brussels, and the time was June 1st, 2011. That's when TEDxKids in Brussels took place. I was just a happy 10-year-old walking around, learning about technology I only heard my dad talk about. And the coolest moment there was when I got to see my glasses I designed a few days earlier, but then 3D printed. It was so cool, I had to know more. So my dad bought us a printer. It was not the best printer, but at the time it was like amazing. So I was playing with the 3D designing software, and yeah, so I got to learn more about design, electronics, and also learning more about industrial processes like casting and vacuum molding. I had a passion that very few people understood, so I started teaching others what 3D printing is. So whenever I could, I would pack my printer and go give demos or workshops to teach people how to 3D design and how to 3D print. After all of these experiences, my father and I thought that I should share my experiences on the TEDxYouth at Flanders stage. So we took a trip to California and we met with the pioneers of this industry. We saw that 3D printing is being used to build cars and robots and special effects in movies. And I went on the stage of TEDxYouth at Flanders in 2012, and I had an audience of 100 kids and 1,100 viewers online. After the TEDxYouth at Flanders talk, I started meeting more people, and those people didn't see me as kids anymore. They asked me about my thoughts and how I see things in the future. So the best thing you can do is surround yourself by people who encourage your ideas and help you reach your goals. And make sure your kid grows up in such an environment where they dare to dream big and explore the unknown. For instance, I met with Jason Dunn. He works for Made in Space, and they sent up the printer to the ISS. And I got to see the prototypes of the printer like a month or so before, and it was amazing. So it was like, wow, the first time. And I also met with Bree Pettis. He's the maker. He was the CEO of the company that made my very first printer. And I also got invited to meet Peter Diamandis, and he's the guy who does Singularity University and X Prizes. Another one of these people was Koen van Pottelberg. He works for Eyes for the World, that's a charity. And meeting him took me back to 2011, when I was making my glasses. And he's giving glasses to the kids in Africa and Asia who cannot afford them, and they're pretty ugly, so, yeah. And the innovative part of this was that the lenses are adjustable, so you can add silicone and make them thicker or thinner, so you could have a pair of glasses that were adjustable from -6 to +6. And I thought the frame itself would have to grow as well, because, you know, a kid grows. So why not 3D print those? I started learning more about 3D printing in developing countries, plastic recycling, and making glasses for any size of head. But all of this would cost money, and who would pay for that? I started giving workshops to design your own glasses, and did charity drives to raise money for Eyes for the World. And at one of those charity drives in December of 2013, I sat together with some people, and we had an idea to make a pair of glasses that would fit perfectly and yet look amazing. The money raised by these glasses, part of it would go to Eyes for the World. So for every pair a person buys over here, they get a pair over there. All of this is still a work in progress, but we're getting fairly close. I'm wearing a pair right now, so if you want to come and see them, you can ask me later. So, that was my journey till date. I shared my experiences with 3D printing with the kids, and I'll share my thoughts on the future with you. In those short 4 years, I learned a lot. Some of the things I learned was that schools cannot teach everything. I learned a lot more outside of school than I learned in school. I learned about robotics, AI, 3D printing, drones, all of that kind of stuff. And school has no idea about those things. I learned these things by going to events like TED and Singularity University and doing more workshops. And I also learned that I can learn from the people I teach too. So if I gave the workshops, I found new challenges. So, oh, you can do it this way. Oh, this is also another way to do it. So I learned more stuff and I improved my skill. And if there aren't any organizations out there that offer your interest, like 3D printing or drones or making aircrafts or whatever, you can create your own. So just get together with some people and organize an event, like have somebody come over or even discuss a TED talk. The same can be done for workshops. So, and help your kids find the balance between school, play, and passion. So my dad, he wants me to get a minimum grade in school. If I don't get that, I can't come to like TEDx events and whatever with him. And I still have enough time to play on my Xbox with my friends. So yeah, still be a kid. And on a more broader scale, I learned a lot of things about the future. And I'll share my thoughts on that with you as well. So, meeting with cool people, I learned that things are moving very, very, very fast. Like, those things are called exponential technologies, and 3D printing is one of them. It will change the speed at new things are being made. So, it will give disruptors a bigger opportunity to change things. Even I'm a disruptor in the eyewear business, so, yeah, in the new future, you don't need to be a big company to make a big difference. The next thing is scary to some people, but robots will steal your jobs. In the future, robots will do the dull, demanding, and dirty work. So that will still put a lot of people out of work. So you need to find new ways to keep yourselves busy and earn money. I don't know what's the best way that's out there, but doing your own thing for the local community works. But also jobs in healthcare and education will always need humans. And the next thing is also a bit scary to some people, but it's quite good. Technology will improve the world. Every new thing can be used for the good and the bad. For example, 3D printing, it can be used to print guns and copy designs and whatnot. But it can also be used to print prosthetics for kids in poor areas. So which is more important? And I think our big future is in outer space. Maiden Space has already sent a printer out there, and if they have any problems, I'm glad to go up there and fix it for them. Just send me a ticket. So this is how I see the future of schools. Schools won't be hierarchies, it'll rather be a network. Kids will get together and they'll learn from each other. For instance, I have a friend called Andreas, and he does a lot of stuff in remote control racing. He has like a car that goes 140 kilometers per hour, and he wants me to print stuff for his car when I learn how the car is actually working. So we like exchange our knowledge. And if this network is even applied online, kids can meet anywhere and everywhere and learn from each other. And schools would be just co-learning spaces, like you have co-working spaces for businesses. And in Belgium, you have two big forms of high school, ASO, which is general education, and TSO, which is technical education. ASO learn theory, and the TSO children learn, practice. In the future school, the theory and the practice needs to be combined. So kids will learn how the theory they learn is applied in the real world. That's something I learned outside of school, but most kids don't get that exposure. So yeah, all of this started by being at the right place at the right time. And I have to thank my dad for taking me to those places at those times.